This video clip will familiarize you with how the veneer skin area is calculated for the different types of column elements. First, for column without veneer, no skin area is calculated. In the case of the rectangular column with veneer, the program calculates the veneer as if it were divided into four parts as shown, so the vertical planes of each are used. For the circular column with veneer, the calculation of the veneer area is based on the plane of the center line of the veneer component. Regular profile column with veneer also has the same method that the rectangular column with veneer has, such as the veneer is divided into four parts when calculating the veneer area. Let's open the profile column in the Profile Manager now. Select it, right-click, and then select Edit Selected Complex Profile from the context menu. The Profile Manager appears. If you select the core, you'll notice that the List Component Area checkbox is unchecked. The veneer has four parts, and all the baselines are located on the middle lines of the parts. Close the Profile Manager now. Now let's open the circular profile column with veneer in the Profile Manager. As you can see, the List Component Area checkbox is unchecked for the core and the veneer consists of one fill only. And for this, the Base Circle Radio button is checked. The base circle is located in the middle of the veneer component segment. When opening the Unique Profile column with veneer to edit in the Profile Manager, you can see the List Component Area is also unchecked for the core. The veneer has several parts which have the baselines on their middle lines. Each baseline is a perpendicular projection of the fill. From the navigator, let's activate Components by Elements Component Template now. As you can see, all types of columns have volume calculations for core and veneer as well. The column without veneer and the general structure core have no area calculations. All other external cladding veneer areas are calculated as mentioned previously.